So Fantastic Beasts, The Crimes of Grindelwald. So this is the next installment, or should I say, milking of the Harry Potter franchise. The plot of it is, Newt Scamander goes to France to locate Credence from the last movie before Grindelwald does. The plot of this movie is just so meaningless and meandering. There's no real central storyline to kind of tie everything together. There's some tonal inconsistency, there's a scene where Grindelwald goes to some muggle's apartment, and that's just wow. There's a scene in a mausoleum that is just way too complicated and makes no sense. I like the last 20 minutes-ish. It sets things up in a nice way for the sequel. David Yates does a pretty good job directing the movie. It feels like we're back in the wizarding world. My only complaint is that he just drains the color out of everything. I would like to see some more vibrant colors. There's a twist in this movie that makes no sense whatsoever. It literally goes against everything Harry Potter lore has previously established. As for the characters, most of them are well cast, but they're just not interesting. Eddie Redmayne is really good Newt's commander. I just don't find myself getting invested in him. Dan Folger once again stands out as Kowalski. Jude Law was a good young Dumbledore, but he should have been in the movie more. Newt's love interest, no personality. His brother, no personality. Nagini, no personality. This guy, no personality. Leader Lestrange, pretty much no personality. Ezra Miller is wasted. He's just a bland character with no real motivation or emotion. Then there's Queenie. Now, she was funny in the previous movie as kind of the ditzy but likable city girl. And then in this film, she's a date rapist, apparently. And she has a character arc that makes no sense. Then there's Grindelwald. I did not hate Johnny Depp in this role as much as I thought I would. He's just not really well written. Towards the end of the movie, he states, oh, I don't hate muggles, you know, I'm not just a rehash of Voldemort. And then earlier in the movie, he literally goes and just murders some muggles. There's potential for a really good villain here. And there's potential for a really complex motivation for him to have, but it's just not presented in a way that really makes sense. They don't know exactly how to make him not just a rehash of Voldemort. All in all, the movie's okay. I mean, there are a lot of great ideas. They're just really wasted. If you ask me, J.K. Rowling should have written this franchise in book form and then let the same people that adapted Harry Potter adapt it. So, yeah, I guess I wasn't a huge fan. I don't have a rating system yet, but I'd probably give it probably a C and maybe a 6.3 out of 10. It could have been a lot better. So yeah, thanks for watching. Be sure to rate, comment, subscribe, and yeah, bye.